may come to note. Brijesh Kalappa of the Congress Party is with us. Mr. Kalappa, how do you feel after exit poll after exit poll has said that your party is going to be reduced to double-digit numbers again?
No, I feel just the same way that we felt in 2004 when every exit poll and every survey had said that Mr. Vajpayee had a massive lead over Sonia ji, and that his approval rating was 56%, while Sonia ji's was only 4%. And I feel just like that. I feel just like how we felt in during exit polls in Bihar and in Delhi and Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. Exactly the same situation prevailed. So I feel just the same way.
I think your party president doesn't feel the same way because he's already blaming the election commission, sir.
Of course, there's plenty to blame the election commission for. There's plenty to blame the election commission for. But certainly, I think as far as what has happened in Kedarnath yesterday and what has been happening about the several clean chits that Mr. Modi has got and the fact that the election commission itself is imploding with one of the members of the election commission speaking out against the election commission. So I think there's plenty to blame the election commission for. But certainly, I think we'll have to wait for the results on 23rd.
But Mr. Kalappa, if I talk about your state, Karnataka, the alliance, it looks, has not worked. Cutting across surveys, you know, the BJP has an upper hand, whereas before the elections was thought, with the consolidation of so much of votes between Kumar Swami's party and your party, you would at least get 20 out of 28.
No, no, 20 out of 28 was a little, I think, because in one or two constituencies, the coalition didn't work very well. But as far as the remaining constituencies, that is 26 on 28, the coalition has worked well. I'm still confident that we'll manage to get 14 to 15 seats out of the total of 28. And I think our performance should not be very bad. Because you must remember that we have a combined vote share of 58%. So there is, I don't think that can be pushed aside. Because arithmetic does have its value. Of course, there is this value of chemistry, political chemistry, but arithmetic does have its value. Mm. You can't just brush aside arithmetic totally and say that, no, it's all chemistry. I don't agree that it's all chemistry.
The arithmetic right now says that the NDA is winning and all of the exit polls are saying it. And the likes of Omar Abdullah have already said on Twitter that everyone cannot be wrong, so it's time to switch off social media. My question to you is if this result is indeed correct, if this is what the figures on 23rd also show, would you say that Rahul Gandhi has failed as a leader? Because starting 2007, I don't know how many elections the Congress has lost under his leadership. Uttar Pradesh certainly has been lost. And this is the first time as party president, he led you into a general election. And if the Congress cannot strike the 100 mark, then that's a huge loss.
No, I don't think, Asiya. First of all, your question is purely hypothetical. So if Rahul Gandhi is going to be blamed for anything, then he should have been credited for the victory in 2009, right? So something went wrong right then. Something went wrong if it did now. So I think, we are not going to look at it straight away by saying that, look, merely because Narendra Modi's leadership costed the BJP, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Chhattisgarh, he ought to have resigned, right? But it's not as simplistic as that. Let's look at the election trends. Let's look at the results. Let's look at what the vote share has been. And finally, I think some kind of voter is sending a message. Then let's try to glean the message from there.
Right. Mr. Kalappa, thanks very much for joining us.